Ramsey, thank you. Thank you for that. So, if you were listening, the Go Down Low song, Mommy, that one's for you. I played that song over the weekend for my mother. And she said, man, that song could wake up the dead.
It's still a problem for with my friends, by the way.
I know, that's my... Actually, Go Down Low was produced by Alex Barnwell. Alex Barnwell is Sid Vincent, better known as Kubiachi, and in 2007, that was actually the song that gave me my big break in 2007, and, you know, put Zoelah on the map internationally as a soca artist. And it's still considered to be one of the finest women's anthem of all time.
Yes, that song is definitely in my playlist.
So I really did my homework, and I'm really proud of myself. All the ladies, all the fellas, listen, especially the fellas be loving this song. Yo. So I want to say big up to all my listeners locked on to YAC Radio right now. It's a Diva Zoelah straight up out of St. Vincent. So I say large to all the Vinci's, Trini's, Grenadines, Jamaicans. You know, Zoelah love you, soca lovers.
So while we're on the subject, let's find out more about Zoelah. So a lot of people, this is their first time, you know, hearing about you. Where are you from originally?
Okay, well, originally I'm from St. Vincent. My homeland, the beautiful island of St. Vincent, the Grenadines. Started, you know, singing from a really young age, at the age of 7, in church and stuff like that. And then from there, at 17, I really started on a professional level. And then by 21, 22, that's when I actually got my big break with Go Down Low. So, you know, okay, they say hard work pays off to the end. And, you know, from 17, before that, it was always a passion of mine to, you know, establish myself as a singer. And, you know, once I got that opportunity, I grasped that. And by the time I was 21, heading to 22 years old, I got my big break with Go Down Low. And from there, the next year was Wine Upon Me. I've been thinking about you, baby. Keep working it. Now wine upon me. Yeah. You know, 2003 consecutive hits, Go Down Low, Wine Upon Me, More Water. Take a look at me, baby. Hold me body and call it. Cause I'm feeling so thirsty. And the temperature rising. More water, more water, more water. Yeah. Things nice.
See, you know, this is I didn't even have to ask. You know what I mean? Normally, I gotta, you know, pull it from people, but she just gave it to me without, so I appreciate that.
You're and welcome.
Your voice is like really strong.
Thank
amazing.
You
train like
No, I've never had voice training.
No.
Wow. I just listened to a lot of Allison Hynes, Edwin Yeah, with Marshall Montana, Super Blue, Kitchener, you name it. A lot of people grew up to, you know, listening when I was a kid. And my mom, you know, I was actually born in Trinidad too, but I grew up in Sydney when I was a baby. So my mom always makes sure that she keep the culture alive in that house because of me. So I would be familiar with my Trini roots.
Yeah. So how does your family feel about your success and about your music? And are they like really big supporters? How did they feel when you first, because you said you, you know, thought you grew up in the church and
well, yeah, I mean, I grew up pretty sheltered. My mom was pretty strict. My family members were pretty strict, you know. St. Vincent is one of those places where, you know, the parentage there is different than most. And I would have to go to church every Sunday like everybody else and join the church group and do all of that. And me and my brother would sing to each other and, you know, we always liked music. But, you know, as far as my family, you know, everybody is very proud of me to see me make that step forward. You know, not everybody get a chance to live their dream, and this is one of the things I always wanted to do since I was a kid. So for me to even have the opportunity to be alive and to be doing it, it's a really big deal. Like, my brothers are really proud of me. I mean, they tell me all the time, so, you know, I guess that's what it is.
So do people recognize you other than, you know, like your own people, West Indian people, like if you're like out and about? Because I know your voice and I know the music, but I never knew what you looked like until today. I mean, or rather until, you know, we started speaking and I knew that you were gonna come on the show. You know, do people ever like approach you and comment about your music?
I've met a lot of people. I've met people in King's Plaza, I've met people in Tracks, I've met people in Manhattan, I've met people in Long Island, I've met people in Queens, I've met people out of state. So, some people recognize me, you know, from, there was a time I used to wear a lot of red in my hair, mm-hmm. and then I toned down, and then, of course, I'm not skinny like before, I'm more woman now, but people still make me out, so, you know, people still give me the love, and I really appreciate it. I want to say big up to all my fans that give me support over the years, all the DJs that give me the support over the years, and everybody locked on.
See, this is what I'm talking about. Okay. So, now, we were talking behind the scenes, and I was saying, like, your music, I've, you know, heard the songs, and a lot of it is very sexual.
Yeah.
So, I would assume that you're a very sexual person.
I mean,
you're not that shy. I mean, with some of the lyrics, you know.
Yeah.
Being that, you know, you were saying, you know, you have, like, the church background.
And I mean, I never said I was a Christian. I'm just
not
saying,
that
like,
you're, no, I'm not saying,
you know,
that you're a saint,
at that time I was a kid, and then, you know, from growing up at a teenage, in my teenage years, you know, I'm going to high school, you get exposed to stuff, but I've always known myself to be one that's never really afraid to express myself. And so when I started doing music in St. Vincent, you know, everybody was like, oh, she sounds like Destra. And I was mad because I wanted to be myself.
Okay.
So I, you know, in order for me to be myself, I have to literally put myself out there and myself, like, to express myself.
Mm-hmm.
I just had to choose what I love to express myself the most on. And, you know, of course, my first time was the best time, so I wanted to share with you. Well, I mean, everybody do this thing. So why
that's
not?
That's true.
Yeah.
You know, I ain't gonna put my business out there, but okay, yeah, that's true. So, all right, I'm gonna kind of just fast forward a little bit to the topic,